Welcome to Polymer Update TV, the world's only TV network with a free petrochemicals news show. It is Tuesday, October 9th. I am Indra Singh. Our special news reel today is sponsored by Pune-based VK Petrochemicals India Private Limited. Let's start with energy and feedstock news. On Monday, crude futures edged lower amid signs that Iranian supply disruptions may not be as severe as expected. Brent finished at $83.91, a fall of 25 cents per barrel, while WTI traded at $74.29, down 5 cents per barrel. According to Vandana Hari of Vanda Insights, crude futures were climbing early Tuesday in Asia with an eye on a few hundred thousand barrels of daily oil production being shut in the US Gulf of Mexico with the approach of an Atlantica hurricane and the shutdown of Canada's largest oil refinery following an explosion on Monday. Open spec naphtha prices declined at the $721 per metric ton CFR Far East Asia levels, a drop of $8 per metric ton from last Friday's assessed levels. Ethylene prices slipped in Asia on Monday. The price decline was triggered by dull buying interest coupled with the improved product availability in the region. CFR Northeast Asia prices were assessed lower at the $1,185 per metric ton levels, a drop of $20 per metric ton from last Friday. CFR Southeast Asia prices of ethylene were assessed at the $1,065 per metric ton mark, a sharp fall of $25 per metric ton from the last Friday's assessed levels. Let's take a look at futures on China Dalian Commodity Exchange for today. On October 9, 2018, LLDPE prices are higher by 40 RMB per metric ton from the previous settlement at the 9,715 RMB per metric ton. PP rates are up by 52 RMB per metric ton from the previous settlement at the 10,386 RMB per metric ton. PVC prices are higher by 45 RMB per metric ton from the previous settlement at the 6,740 RMB per metric ton. In plant news, Lanzhou Petrochemical has undertaken a plant shutdown at its 300,000 metric ton per year HDPE or LLDPE swing plant located in Gansu province of China on October 8, 2018 for a maintenance turnaround. The plant is expected to resume production on October 14, 2018. Oriental Energy-Ningbo has restarted its 400,000 metric ton per year polypropylene plant located at Ningbo of China in September 2018. The plant was shut on September 12, 2018 for a maintenance turnaround. Polymer Update has introduced news and price analysis on Amazon Alexa virtual assistant using Echo and other devices. The platform lets subscribers check latest news and prices just by asking Echo or any other Alexa-enabled device. This is the first of its kind on Amazon Alexa, so do read the kind of questions that you can ask to Amazon Alexa about Polymer Update. Our special news reel today is sponsored by Pune-based VK Petrochemicals India Private Limited, a manufacturer of PP talc field, PP glass field, LLDPE roto compounds, pre-color PP, LDPE, HDPE, nylon 6, ABS, GPPS and HIPS. That's all for today's Polymer News. Watch our daily news video tomorrow to know more. It is Tuesday, October 9th. This is Indra Singh. Thank you.
Find us on Facebook at facebook.com/polymerupdate and be sure to click the like button. You can also find us on Twitter at polymerupdate. For the latest news from the plastics and petrochemicals industry, subscribe to our YouTube channel and do not forget to hit the bell icon.